All right. Hey everyone. I'm trying this OBS software. Bear with me for a minute. All right. So, I thought I would try this making of video, if I could. Make sure I'm set here. Anyway. I've been getting a lot of questions on my process about these cover videos I do. So I thought I would try and break it down somehow. So we're looking at Logic here, Logic Pro, and I figured I'd pick the last song I did, which was Bill Bruford's Beelzebub, great jazz fusion track. You fusion heads will all know. So, make sure we're good here. Hold on, 1 second. Alrighty then. Okay. Yeah, let me know if you guys are seeing this and if it sounds good. All right. So anyway, so basically, my first step is which tune, and they're all like my personal favorites that I've dug over the years, and I often challenge myself, as you've heard. So basically, the process. Is first I will do a tempo match. I use a click track for everything. So I'll use a few references, the original track, you know, multiple, a live version, whatever I could find, three or four versions of the song, and find the average tempo. Most of these tunes didn't use click tracks back in the day. So some might think they're a little rigid, but, yeah, either way, it's good practice as a drummer, or guitar, or bass, whatever, to, play to a click track. So I'll find a nice tempo. Hey, there's Uncle Nelson. How's it sound? Is this working? Here, I'll play a second of the song. Huh? Yeah. So first thing I will do... Hold on, let me turn off, let's see. Drums. The live instruments. Guitar. Bass, drums. First I have to analyze the tune. As you can see, this one has time signatures out the ass. So I first figure it out. This is what I would hear as a click. So hold on, let me put on the cheesy fake instruments. Hey Dante, what's up? So, as you can see, this, a lot of folks are like, what time signature is this? It's 9/8, mainly. So this is, first I have to input everything. Um, So as you can see up top, these time signatures are all over the place. Look at this part. Count along. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Alright. So there's that. My favorite instrument. Yeah. Drums. Right. I started out on drums as a wee little tyke. My older brother, also a drummer. Still going to this day. My sister plays keys. My dad sang, played keys. My uncle Nelson, who's here, was in the... We had like a Partridge Family band going called the Generation Gap. I was drumming, I don't know, I was like 14 years old or something. Playing firehouses and before DJs and stuff like that. Yeah, so, where was I? Okay, so yeah, I'll have to figure out, you know, all the parts, the bass line, keyboards. Keyboards is usually pretty rough. Now with keys, I like to, find the original sounds, just by listening. Like, here's the clav. Let's see, is this one? Ah, got a weird delay. Wow. So yeah, I had to figure this out. So yeah, just knowing all these instruments, whether it's whether the video was a Sting tune or a Eddie Jobson, the organs, the Moogs. I love trying to recreate all these sounds. So. This particular tune, it was a clav, as you can hear. But obviously there's a phaser here. You could hear the phaser. EQ-wise, here's what that looks like. So you'd want to... Most tracks, if you can see here... Hold on. Bring that down. You want to roll off all unnecessary information down there. And I'm just brightening it up a little bit right here, as you can see. So yeah, I have to input all this in, and it's click track, and these are like quantized, really cheesy, totally in time, baseline, quantized, everything. Because I'm gearing up to do drums, which is usually my first thing. I'll do drums along with all these fake instruments. Yeah, I had cheesy drums in here. Here you go. Quantized. Now this bass line is a mess. I can't figure the logic behind it. This is what it looks like at a step view. Something like that, you know. You can follow along. It's really strange. Oh, I come to find out I played wrong notes. This E should be an F. I have to redo the whole video now. So there's the bass. Let's see. And then for the bass track, I use just East-West. Samples. Just a Lakeland mono, converted to mono. Mono bass track. Whatever. Whatever sound. Guitar, which you know was Alan Ellsworth. That was scary, trying to recreate that. So I had cheesy guitar right here. You can follow along up top. That offbeat tambourine. Yurt. Classic Bruford. Okay, so there's that. The fake guitar, organ. Organ, I like just the stock Logic organ. Got a weird delay in here. I love this part. Ooh, yeah. How'd that go again? Something like that, right? Yeah. is that right? That's right, yeah. Oh yeah, that's right. Stupid. Yeah, so good old organ. The Leslie. Move that down a little bit. There it is. A little distortion, of course. What else do we have? I added strings, which aren't on the record. So you figure, keyboards of the era, which I used the Selena, probably remember that, this thing, for that. So again, depending on the tune, I'll try and use the keys of that era. You know, if it was Sting or something, the 90s, Yamaha DX7s, I have the Arturia collection. Hold on. Hold on one sec. Do you have any questions? Hit me up. This is a first. I'm doing this live thing. Pretty interesting. I know it's Sunday. Everyone's probably out. This nice weather. But I just wanted to get this under the belt. What else do we have? We had the vibes, east-west vibes. Here, marimba, added the marimba in there. Okay, so we had that going. Then it's drum time. Woo! thanks, man. Yeah, if you guys, I know you're probably busy now. Check it out later, this video, if you're interested in my mindless chatter. So then it's drum time. As you can see, it's a few takes. I'm not going to get it on the first take. Unfortunately, can't really cheat. Well, I don't like to cheat. I'm punching in with the drums. It's just hit it. So this was the Rototom kit. You probably saw pictures, and it's all mic'd up. I have the what do we have? Some Neve preamps. As you can see, so here's the breakdown. Bass drum. You can see. You can see the EQ curves here. They're hit pretty hard, you know. There you go. Bass drum, which was, what was it? D112. What else do we have? The snare. Just a 57. I usually don't mic the bottom. We had the Rotos. We actually only used the 12, 14, and 16 cranked really high. 12. So yeah, the 12, 14, 16. Here's the EQ again. The high pass, the unnecessary info. No gating. 14, 16. Hi-hat. The toms, by the way, were just the old Sennheiser 604s, I believe. AKG 451 on the hi-hat. Overheads are nice Sheps. MK, I forget the model number. MK something. They're sweet. And then a nice room mic, which was the AEA stereo ribbon, which is really sweet. And typical of room mics right here. You will beat the crap out of it, compression-wise. Attack all the way down so there's no transients. Because you're getting the transients from the close mics. This one didn't have much room sound. Something like the Zappa one or Foo Fighters, Hendrix, Chris Cornell. They had, you crank up the room mic. So I compressed that room mic. I'm not compressing individually. And then all the drums go to a master bus. Over here. Hold on. Yeah. And then I'll just do kind of a safety compression. Whoops. That's not it. Where is it? Oh, yeah. Here it is. Just a safety. Now, this one, you can see it's the drums on. Hold on. That's the fake drums. So here's the drums. Yep. Yeah. Turn off the click track. Drums. I'm hitting it hard compression-wise on the master bus, drum bus. Because it was the 70s. And I always use this Clone 1176 compressor. So that's what it looks like. I'll just barely hit the minus 10 reduction. What else? And then there's a little bit of a room. Is there a room? Yeah. Just to recreate from what was on the album, which was probably a nice plate or something. Let's see, hold on. I had a couple comments here. Thanks, Oz. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Guitar was my, my secondary instrument. I hit that pretty hard. And bass came pretty easy. No big deal. Keys, I'm getting there on the keys. what else? So that was the drums. So yeah, that's basically where I'm at. So far we had that, you know, no real bass. The keys, by the way, they were done first, so I'll get them good, click track wise, you know, the sound choices and all that. So I'm hearing good keyboard parts, so that's theoretically done first. Of course, I'll edit mistakes. Everything you're hearing's pretty clean by the time it's published. Keyboard-wise, MIDI-wise, I'm not that great as a keyboardist. In fact, half the time I have to slow down the master tempo doing these things. Just to get it nice. So that's what I'm hearing as I'm drumming. I'll do the drums. I set up, my drums are in another room out here, and I have my little iPad, which controls this Logic. And the video, of course, which is that camera you probably see back here. The old Sony. just 1020 by 1080. 1080. It's not a 4K situation. My computer is kind of old, believe it or not. A 2010 Mac Pro. It's blown out with SSDs and RAM, and it's totally maxed out. But if it ain't broke, you know, but one of these days it's going to be time to upgrade. So yeah, that's what I'm hearing for any of the tunes, is usually the keyboard tracks done correctly. The bass, quantized, cheesy, you know, so I'm hearing the bass, whatever, guitar parts. What else? So yeah, I'll video myself doing the drums, and if that's a go, fine. I usually move on to the bass, which is this guy here. Well, that was a Moog, but here's the bass. So I had to chart this out and read it. So the bass is just my trusty old, what is it, Ibanez thing? Nothing crazy. It's a 5-string. And I'll put it through the Universal Audio 6176 preamp compressor EQ flat. And roll off the unnecessary. Since it was not a 5-string back in the day, you know, low E was it. So you can roll off around 40 hertz being the fundamental of an E. The low B note is about 32 hertz, so you'd want to back this off if you're tapping into a 5-string modern thing. So I kind of just got rid of some unnecessary noise, subsonic noise down there. And then this particular tune, went through this thing. These are all Logic plugins, I gotta say. EQ. I have all the waves and I don't even use them. Just the stock EQs, stock compressors. So yeah, I purposely used this, purposely distorted it a little, and then blend the real direct bass with this plugin. So that's the bass. And as you can see, I punched in a couple times. So basically what I would do, I video it myself playing it all the way through live. You know, this is all live, these parts. And then I might go back if I mess something up, fix it audio wise, not video. Video, unfortunately, it's the same. So yeah, there's that, punched in a lot on that one. And if that's a go, it came down the friggin' Alan Holdsworth. Ooh, shizzum. Believe it or not, this was it one? This was one take. I had to learn the solo, of course. I had to one part after all these years. You know, I never really learned it. Actually had this. So you know what? I got to slow down this one part. One of those apps where you can slow down the tune. 50%, whatever. So the fast part of a solo. Where is that? No, it's coming. I think it's over here. That. So it's obviously not accurate. But I was just curious, you know, what he was doing. So the solo, yeah, that's my little interpretation. And guitar-wise, it's usually through this Mesa Boogie right here. And the cabs out there are like a 2x12 with either the V30 or the old EVM 12L. And it's usually mic'd up with the Ribbon R84 mic. Just the one mic. I don't really get into all that 57 Ribbon situation. And then through a preamp, either the Neves, or I got this, this is the 5211, it's a pretty nice two-channel pre. Yeah, so I'll do that. I'll video myself wherever, you know. Usually that was in this room. And I'll just put the camera wherever. And I got the little ring light, as you can see. So that's that. I do the guitar. Let me think. What else do we got? I could show you. So if vocals were involved on the tune, whatever, if it was Sting or Peter Gabriel or Badfinger, Pink Floyd, I forget all the videos I did. I can't believe how many I did since COVID. Level 42, that was the first one I did. yeah, that was whatever. What was the mic? Either a Neumann, that one, and what is it? 147? A nice tube. Or the U87. Or the Shure, that right there, SM7. And that hits the same Universal Audio preamp. And the same deal, roll off unnecessary high pass. Hold on. Yeah, okay. So, yeah, that was my vocal chain. And then, I like this Elephant Maximizer. It's pretty nice. Boxengo Elephant, it's called. You can hear it. So here it is without. Ready? Great. There you go. So that's my signal. It's pretty safe. You can see down here. Not clipping. So then, I like to hit it. Here you go. Nice grab. Usually just bass drum, snare drum. Hitting this thing. 3, 4 dB worth. It's a nice plug-in. It's either that or the Waves Maximizer, but this is nice. I recommend. Oh yeah, that was the guitar line. That was the only riff I had to punch in. Where is it? Yeah, that was it. Here it is, right here. So yeah. So I think that's it. Let me get out of here a second. So let me quit Logic for a second. See if I can. Don't save. No. That's Ivy drew this. Pirate Ship, by the way, for my Learning Tree album. Let me see if I can open up Final Cut. So then it's time to dump the videos into Final Cut. That's what I use. See if this works. Hold on. Yeah. Okay. Hold on. Let me get one screen. There we go. So there's Final Cut. This and there's Beelzebub, the last tune I happen to do. So I bounce the track from Logic. Here it is on the bottom. You know, the finished version. Throw in each video. This particular one just had the four drum, bass, guitar keys. What's the? I think it's 24 frames per second for the video. And I just immediately turn the saturation off and mess with exposures. Usually drop the mids in the exposures. That's about it. Yeah, and do some fades, put my little splash ending there, that thing, and so yeah, that's the process. So I'm really glad you guys. I can't believe all the responses over the past 3 years. It's really been great. I appreciate it. So yeah, who knows what the next tune will be. And it's always a treat getting other people involved. I've had a lot, Chris Giraldi, Jason Long, Rob Swanson, all kinds of people on these videos. So it's fun to do that. So yeah, let me close this. I hope this video worked. All right. Well, so that's a little insight into the old video process. So thanks, guys. And I'll catch you on the next one. Cool. Thanks.